What is going on, football fans? Just wanted to get another quick video up on the page. I meant to get it up earlier, but I was so busy today. I had a lot of things going on. But a lot of news came out from OTAs, and we'll start with the quarterback position. Of course, that's always going to be the hot topic, especially after we took Daniel Jones with the sixth overall selection. So we'll start there. Daniel Jones actually got more reps with the second team than he's gotten so far throughout OTAs. He split reps there with the second team, I believe, with Alex Tanny. He was taking reps with the third team previously. So I do think you're going to start to see him taking more and more reps with the second team. They'll probably try to integrate him a little bit with the first team as well in the OTAs. Now it was rainy out. They said that Eli Manning looked sloppy, much like he did the first day of OTAs in the first week. He threw an interception. I believe Antoine Bethea came up with it, which was good to hear, the newly acquired safety. But they said Eli overall looked pretty sloppy. Daniel Jones didn't look great as well from everything that I heard. He threw a pick, but supposedly it went right through the rookie receiver Slayton's hands. But overall, they said both quarterbacks were mediocre. It sounded as if Eli was a little worse. So we'll see where that goes. Again, I'm not going to read too much into the OTAs with a veteran quarterback like an Eli Manning. I don't think that Pat Shurmur will either. We're probably not going to get a good read on how the quarterback situation is going to go until preseason. But I still think Eli, pretty much no matter what, will be the opening day starter and probably will be the starter for at least 4, 5, 6 weeks. And then, you know, depending on how he plays, we'll see if we get to see Daniel Jones this year. But, yeah, that was the news there with the quarterback. The center position was a little bit of a surprise. Of course, we all thought John Halapio, who was the opening day starter last year, was going to be the starter this year, and he probably very well may be. But Halapio actually today was taking second-team reps. Spencer Pulley, who we signed, took the first-team reps today. So there may be a little bit of a competition there that we did not see coming at the center spot. So we'll have to wait and see. Stay tuned for that. Also, Sterling Shepard, they said, had a very good day on the outside. But what I did read was, from everybody there, they seem to think that this offense this year is going to be a lot of checkdowns, a lot of underneath routes, and that's kind of what we expected after, of course, we lost Odell Beckham. We brought in Golden Tate, who is kind of known for those short and intermediate routes. I expect this to be a ball control offense. I don't see a lot of big plays from this offense this year. We'll see if Shepard can expand his game. I think he is capable of playing on the outside. He has demonstrated that before. Of course, when Odell Beckham went down a few years ago, and he played fairly well. Evan Engram is going to need it to take a huge step up this year if this offense wants to be somewhat dynamic. But overall, I think it's going to start and end with Saquon Barkley. I think everybody knows that. That's pretty much it as far as the offense goes. As far as the defense goes, Janoris Jenkins was, from what I read, I think was the only guy who missed OTAs, which was good to hear, of course, because these are voluntary. You know, and you hear that Odell Beckham's not showing up to his OTAs. You know, a lot of players don't show up to the OTAs. But it seems as if the Giants are all on the same page. They're all buying in, which is what you want to hear. And everything I read was Janoris Jenkins had a legitimate excuse. It had something to do with his family. I didn't read all the specifics, but Jenkins wasn't there, which was nice, actually, because we got to see some of the younger corners play and get first-team reps. Corey Ballantyne did not get first-team reps, but he played, of course, coming back from getting shot. So that was nice to hear that he's on the football field, and maybe he can make a bit of a difference. All the young cornerbacks, though, got some first-team reps, of course, with DeAndre Baker, Sam Beal, everybody else. And from what I read, they look pretty good. You know, of course, they're going to look good when the offense doesn't look that good. From everything you read, the offense looks sloppy today as far as the quarterback position goes. The other thing I wanted to touch on was Dexter Lawrence. Once again, was getting outside reps. The 340-pound nose tackle they had lined up on the DN spot, and he was with the second team. So it'll be interesting to see how much they implement him as a defensive end in this defense this year. That is something I did not see coming. Maybe they're trying to test to see if he has some versatility. I think everybody thought he was going to replace Snacks in that interior position, especially because B.J. Hill was pretty successful at getting after the quarterback last year. But maybe they plan on using him more on the outside than we had initially anticipated. We're going to have to monitor that situation. And that's pretty much all that there was to report today on OTAs. Not a lot of other big news, but some things to hit on. We'll see how the quarterback position continues to progress as the week goes forward. But as always, if you liked what you watch, please subscribe, drop a comment, maybe give me a little thumbs up. Cheers.